Hi friends, in this video we'll discuss about the dip painting simulation in ANSYS Fluent. So you can see on the screen there is a part which is present inside a volume. So that is a combination of water plus air. So you can see this is the origin. So below the origin I will try to fill entirely with water, and above I will leave it with air. So when you try to remove the part from the water, how exactly water has been distributed on the particular part. So it is like representation of a, that you are immersing some object in a paint and you are removing it from a paint. And we will also apply voltage to this plate and walls of the fluid, so that it would be like electrostatic dip painting, where the electrostatic effect or the electric field effect will also enhance the abstract or stuck of water or any paint onto the plate. So it's like when you try to apply this electric field, these force the molecules which are having electrical conductivity like water or any paint that would try and go to adhere onto the plate surface, right? So by this way we'll try to increase the friction force. It's like increasing the normal force. As you increase the normal force, the adherence or the friction force would also increase, and it tries to stick onto the plate when you're trying to pull the plate from the paint or in our present scenario water, right? So that is an overview of what exactly we are intend to do in this tutorial. So I'll just proceed with Fluent case. So this is our mesh. I'll try to give a transient condition, because obviously we are going with the remove of the plate from the water in the present scenario, or in exactly you can take it as paint also if you have the paint properties. And then you go to for models, go for multiphase, click on volume of fluid model, and also click on implicit body force, click apply, close, go with the laminar, okay, close this model, just try to activate potential lithium ion battery potential equation. This is important, as I've already stated, this potential equation helps to give the voltage to the walls of the fluid, so that these walls potential will help the particles to move and adhere onto the plate. So go to materials, try to copy the water liquid from the Fluent database. Then go to boundary conditions. So these are the walls what I try to mention. So wall positive means wall potential, wall potential positive what we need to give. So just go to the potential tab and go to the specified value. Here I'll try to give 100 volts as my potential, click OK. On the negative side, just go to the negative side and you can give potential here. So the value is 0, leave it as 0, okay. And after that you can just check it by going to display mesh, what is positive side and what is negative side. So you can check, this is positive wall and this is the negative wall what I am trying to give the voltage. And just go to the multi-phase model again to assign the air and water to the different phases here. So this is water, liquid, right? And in the phase interaction you just go to the surface tension modeling, have this wall adhesion which tries to give a adhesion force between the water and as well as air with respect to the wall, what is the wall adhesion value. And the surface tension coefficient I'm giving constant here, which is 0.072. Apply, close, And now I'll try to create a dynamic mesh for the plate. So this is the velocity what I am intend to give for the plate. So it has a linear motion with respect to y direction, and initially at time 0 the velocity is 0, and at the time 1 the velocity is 5 meters per second for the plate. So I'll try to give that profile to the plate. So go on, activate dynamic mesh, smoothing, remeshing, go to create zone. And sorry, meshing. These values you need to copy and assign to the minimum length scale and those parameters list. For every two iterations, I try to ask for the checking and for remeshing option. Okay, close it. Go to create edit. And for deforming, this is the interior what I want to deform. So create. And now I'll try to read that profile what I have mentioned. So read the profile. So it is the profile what I have shown here with respect to time, how the velocity of the plate is been differed. So I've already had this simulation ran, so I'll try to read it from that only. So this is the profile. Okay, go to create edit. Now go to rigid body, go to the plate wall, and I'm trying to assign the linear motion for that. Click on create, close. So one is deforming and the plate wall is rigid, right? In the methods, I will go to the methods. So I'll try to assign a coupled scheme and go to initialize. And before initialization, just you go to refine coarsen, where you need to assign the region with water liquid, right? So go to cell registers, new region. So anything below 0 should be water for us. So maximum is 000, minimum you take minus 50. This also minus 50. And these two also minus 50. I save and display. Yes. So you can see the below region only part is with click save and display. Minimum. Okay, so these. So these are the values. It is minus 20, 20, minus 20, 0, minus 10, 10. So you can just check it with the space claim and give, enter the values such that the x-axis minimum on the other side, x-axis maximum on this side. So I've calculated and mentioned here. After that, click on close. Okay, now try to initialize it. So now you need to patch the bottom part with water. So this is the region 0, you need to patch with water. So try to go to phase 2, which is water liquid for us. Click on volume fraction and select these regions to patch. As it is water, patch it with 1. Patch. Then close. Run calculation. Select our time step as 0.01. Prove time steps as. Click on calculate. So after running through few time steps, I have just stopped it and brought it to the ANSYS CFD post. So now this is the plate wall. I'll just click on the plate wall and I'll try to mention it as a variable, with the variable as a phase 2 volume fraction, that is water liquid, and click on local apply. So now you can see, and I'll try to create an ISO volume where it shows entire water part only. So I'll try to go all domains, the methods, ISO volume, the volume fraction of water we need to have. So phase 2 below value 1, so anything below 1 it will try to show it to us. I'll try to color with the volume fraction of the water itself. So, in terms of local, I'll try to give, and I'll render with some transparency so that it will have a pleasing look for us. So it will show, yeah, it should be above 1. Okay, above 0, so it is above 0. So yeah, now it is showing a water level exactly where the water is. So now we will try to apply. So that is a 0 time step where the plate would be. It is completely immersed inside the water. So now the plate is here. I saw the plate is completely immersed. So now as you try to remove it from the water, what exactly is happening? So I'll try to go into this time step, click apply. So now you can see that the plate would be removed from the water, and the water fraction that is present on the plate would be displayed here. So you can see it is being removed. As it is being removed, some water is being adhered on to the plate. You can see what is the amount that is being getting adhered onto the plate. So here maximum amount is getting adhered due to this curvature, but here minimum amount is getting adhered, right? So that adhering property is one due to the viscosity nature, and other due to this potential equation what we have given, that was increasing the viscosity in terms of a friction due to the increase of the normal force. So normal force is being increased, as I have said, due to the flow of the charged particles over the plate due to the potential difference. So this is what about in brief about dip painting using electric potential as your catalyst inside the painting. So I hope this video has helped you guys in understanding the dip painting, how to perform it using ANSYS Fluent simulation. Please do subscribe the channel and encourage me for doing more number of videos. Thank you.